Good morning, students. In the previous video, I have explained about the author. So today, I think before beginning the story, teaching line by line, let us learn the summary of the lesson so that you have some idea about the story, isn't it? So listen carefully. In this story, there are three main characters. Ranji. Ranji is the hero of this story. And Koki. Koki is the heroine. And Mohinder Singh. Mohinder Singh is Ranji's friend. So one day, Ranji had a one rupee old coin. He took the coin and went to Jumna Sweet Shop to buy jalebi. When he reached the counter, he tossed the coin and asked for jalebi of 1 rupee. The shopkeeper examined very carefully the coin and he said that this coin has no use. It is of no use, so you cannot get jalebi. So Ranji turns back and went away on the road and wandering in the market, in the bazaar. Meanwhile, he heard a familiar voice saying, "Where are you going?" In surprise, he turns back and finds his friend Mohinder Singh with fishing rod. Ranji said, "I am going nowhere. Where did you go?" Mohinder Singh explained, saying that he had gone for fishing in the canal, but he did not catch anything. So Ranji asked for the fishing rod. "Will you give me your fishing rod, or will you lend me your fishing rod?" Mohinder says, "No, I will not give you. If I give, you may lose or you may break it. But I am ready to sell for 2 rupees. Ranji said, I have only 1 rupee and that is also of no use. Mohinder says, "Show me the coin." He takes and examines the coin and says, "It is really of no use. But since my uncle collects old coin, I am ready to give you my fishing rod with 1 rupee. You can have it." Ranji took the fishing rod and said goodbye to Mohinder and set off towards the river. When he was going through the road, he saw a truck. Since he knew the truck's driver, he shouted loudly, "Stop, stop and stop." The driver stops the truck. He climbs up on the truck and goes to the river. When he reaches the river bed, he gets down and started walking up and down in the bank of the river. But he does not find deep water, not even small fish, because it was the summer season. So I started getting angry to Mohinder. Because of this situation, Ranji has sold this fishing. Sorry, Mohinder has sold this fishing rod. So I started going back again towards the bazaar in the hot summer. So when he was coming back, he again thinks of jalebi, which he could not bought in the beginning. So when he was coming back, on the way he finds some scattered house. And there, in the stillness of the summer season, one boy was playing a melodious flute. He goes near to that boy and he stares at the flute. On the other side, even that boy, when saw the fishing rod in Ranji's hand, he was staring at that fishing rod. So when he goes near to that boy, he said that you are very good player. Can you give me to play your flute? And he took the flute and started playing. He made such a bad noise that birds which were sitting on the mango tree all flew away. But for Ranji, it was a very melodious sound. He liked, he enjoyed. On the other side, this boy was busy in looking at this fishing rod. And for some time, there was a quiet silence. After a few moments, Ranji said, "Fishing rod is very good." Even that boy said, "My flute is also very good. Will you exchange?" Ranji said. And they made exchange without any delay. With that flute, Ranji started moving towards the bazaar. When he reached the clock tower, and when he was going, he was playing the flute. And those people who were passing by that way, they were all surprised. What kind of this boy is? He doesn't know how to play, but he is playing the flute. But on the other hand, Ranji thought that he is playing the best and he was enjoying so nicely. When he reached the clock tower, he had encounter with one milk boy. This milk boy said, "I can play better than you." So Ranji offered him, "Okay, you can play my flute if you know better than me." So this boy started playing so melodious voice, and all the people were very happy to listen the way he was making melodious sound. So Ranji said, "Since you know better than me to play the flute, you can buy this flute in 2 rupees. I am ready to sell." But the milk boy said that, "I don't have any money. I have few cans and one necklace. If you want to exchange your flute with a necklace, I am ready." So they exchange with necklace. This necklace was very beautiful, made out of Tibetan stones, which was very beautiful. So Ranji exchanged the flute with this necklace. And he was maybe seeing this necklace very carefully. Meanwhile, he noticed Someone was also staring towards the necklace, and it was none other than Koki, the one who was staying just beside the Ranji's house. So Koki liked the necklace and she wanted to buy the necklace. So Ranji sold this necklace to Koki with 1 rupee. Koki gave Ranji 1 new coin. As soon as he got that 1 rupee coin, he ran towards the Jumna sweet shop. This time with great proud, he goes to the counter and tosses the coin. Again the shopkeeper examines the coin, and this time he offers a full bag of jalebi. After taking the jalebi, Ranji once again comes back towards the clock tower, where he finds that Koki was waiting for him. As soon as Ranji reaches there, Koki with shy smile says that she is also hungry. So both of them went little aside and sat together side by side and ate the jalebi happily. And afterwards they became the best friend. So this is the summary of this story, and I hope it is really very interesting one, how 1 rupee travels from so many ways, so many means, and finally whatever the hero of this lesson wanted to achieve, finally he achieved. Thank you.